Welcome to episode 8 of My Friend Thimbleweed Park. I'm your host, Lostwolfe. And today, we've got like this whole thing happening. Let's see if we can open the lumpy sheet and see what's going on.
Ah! You scare-a-renoed me! I mean, scare-a-hooed me!
Whatever. What is that creepy violin music?
I have no idea. It comes through the plumbing. Okay, back to sleep-a-hoo.
Well, now we do have context for two things. The first thing is that Willie must be in the sewers playing Stradivarius, because he made violin music when we opened up the sheet. And the second thing, of course, is that we do now know that for sure, because they mixed sort of the characters up here, that the coroner and the sheriff are almost certainly the same person. Some weird stuff is going on at Thimbleweed Park. Right, so...
Stay out of my way, and you might learn something.
We've got our fingerprint report, as you saw in the last episode. And one of the things that we didn't do when we were in A Street was we didn't go into the Thimbleweed Nickel. So there are lots of little newspapers everywhere here. I'll look at them and then we'll go and talk to the person who is the owner of the nickel.
It's a color copy Tron 3000.
That's good to know.
These must contain journalistic gold or old classified ads. I don't want to open it.
So we can't get in there? But there's lots of newspapers, so let's look at those. So this filmmaker, Hannibal Finch, scouting Thimbleweed as film location. This particular one is a direct sort of in-joke here where it's talking about surrealist filmmaker Hannibal Lynch, and this can only mean David Lynch, and he's scouting Thimbleweed as a film location. I want to tell you that Twin Peaks was several years in the future, but obviously this is riffing on that. Okay. Horror author mentioned Merton Steele finds inspiration for book after stay at Edmund Hotel. I think this is either Stephen King or Daniel Steele, one of those two people. But I don't think it wouldn't be Daniel Steele, because it's a horror book. So it may just be Stephen King. Madame Morena says, I told you so, as Sheriff eats that after stunning TV wrestling defeat. Cryptozoologists and UFO enthusiasts flood into town after tentacle sighting. This, of course, is from Data Tentacle. Local groundskeeper wins holy award. Doug Braverman has won the long overdue award. We will meet Doug at some point. Mime caught in compromising clown car caper. 21 accomplices sought. I don't have much to add with that one. It's just a silly funny pun. A cult oddball, Madame Marina warns town of purple meteor strike in the coming days. That's a riff again on Maniac Mansion. Lenore Edmund arrested for DUI as she screamed, "Do you know who I am?" That seems like a very her thing to do. Skank sets off smoke alarm in Quickie Pal bathroom. Quickie Pal Leonard, oblivious. True. Sorry. Thought she would move to the next one over, but she did not.
Welcome to the Thimbleweed Nickel. 8 years of experience and 2 degrees in journalism tells me you're a fed.
Okay, I didn't mean to talk to her, but now that we're here, let us do that. Do you offer home delivery?
Do you offer home delivery?
Why? You plan on moving here?
Not a chance.
Okay. We'll need a complete press blackout.
We'll need a complete press blackout.
Not with the First Amendment still in place. The core of a strong democracy is a strong press.
And now you can chase this as a rabbit hole pretty far. I'm not going to do that. I'm going to do 3 of them. But it's a sort of smart and funny joke in the sense that she will tell you what the amendments do because you keep getting it wrong. So don't you mean the Fifth Amendment?
Don't you mean the Fifth Amendment?
Nope. That sets out rules for indictment by grand jury in eminent domain and protects the right to due process.
Don't you mean, she's going to say the Fifth Amendment again.
Don't you mean the Fifth Amendment?
But she will go through different ones. It picks them at random, as you saw. So here's the 20th Amendment.
Don't you mean the 20th Amendment?
Nope. That changes the date on which the terms of the President, Vice President, Senators, and Representatives begin and end.
Don't you mean the 10th Amendment?
Don't you mean the 10th Amendment?
Nope. That reinforces the principle of federalism by stating that the federal government possesses only those powers delegated to it by the states or the people through the Constitution.
And like I say, you can just go chasing this down like a little rabbit hole. But it's not necessary for fulfilling the conversation, so we're not going to do that. We're here investigating the murder. You know anything? What's the deal with the sheriff? Seems a little odd arena.
What's the deal with your sheriff? Seems kind of odd arena.
He is an oddball, but so is everyone around here. And it's only gotten worse since Chuck died.
Chuck?
Chuck?
Chuck Edmund, the pillow magnet. He pretty much ran this town since the 50s and owns the giant pillow factory. Well, owned. He died a few days ago. His niece Dolores and her sister Lenore stand to inherit a fortune if they'll just stop fighting.
Okay, what else do you know about Chuck?
What else do you know about Chuck?
He started the pillow factory with his brother Franklin in the late 30s to make pillows for the war effort. Pillows win wars was their slogan. The factory and Chuck were the center of the Thimbleweed social scene of the 50s.
Go on, fascinating, intriguing. Jeez, not that into pillows. Go on.
Go on.
Chuck invested millions in automation and became an expert in AI.
And this is a joke that's going to come up a lot. Agricultural investment? Agri intervention. Hardbuck insemination. Let's go with agricultural investment.
Agricultural investment?
Artificial intelligence. Computers that can think. He started automating the whole town. People tell me it was like living in the future. That's one of his machines over there. The Copytron 3000. Then?
What? Keep going. Tell me more. Pillows, Chuck, Magnate's got it. Kinda bored now.
What?
The big pillow factory fire happened and killed several workers, and the whole place was shut down. Many blame the fire on over-automation and computer error. But I think Chuck manipulated the sheriff, and it was blamed on the security guard on duty at the time. But it was too late. Chuck was disgraced, and the factory's been closed for years. A dark shell of abandoned machinery.
Interesting. We're here investigating the murder. Know anything?
We're here investigating the murder. Know anything?
Not much. Just what I heard over the police scanner. Body found in the river. I'll send my best reporter to check it out in the morning. Know who my best reporter is?
You sigh. You shrug. You rolls eyes. You Clark Kent. I like the Clark Kent answer. This again is a joke because Superman and Clark Kent are the same person, and Superman worked for a newspaper.
Clark Kent.
If this damn town wasn't such a podunk, I'd have a couple of Pulitzers by now. This pillow factory fire story is my ticket out of here.
Okay. Nice chatting. Got a murder to solve.
Nice chatting. Got a murder to solve.
Okay. There we go. Chuck Edmund wins a lot of money in Quickie Pal Lotto using his lucky number 139. Okay, so we had been looking at the correct one. I think we've seen all of them. We haven't seen this one. Mystery violin music is driving townsfolk mad, say local conspiracy theorists. Well, we know where that's coming from, don't we? Baby gators escaped from pet emporium. Are the sewers their new home? Quite possibly. S&D Diner attempts world record for biggest thimbleweed pie. Thimbleberry pie. Deemed inedible. Given what we know about their food, that is probably the case. Botulism scared. S&D Diner. Health inspectors cite hot dogs. Asshole. Riot at the Hitchin Post after erroneous razor and the scumette sighting. Okay, there's also a map of the town.
It's a map of the Tri-Thimbleweed Park County area.
And then there's a sort of a...
Gutenberg would be proud.
Fun thing happening here. Thimbleweed Nickel. Est. 19. Now, there's a problem here where we can't move enough to see when it was established. But, there's also a joke related to that here.
Thimbleweed Nickel. Established 19.
So, the joke obviously is that not even she can see past the spot here to tell us when it was established. But there's another Tron machine here. Interesting.
Please don't mess with the police scanner. I'm waiting for a call from the sheriff's office about a woman by the diner and a possible car accident.
Okay, that's good to know. Alright, so let's head out. Okay. So, we have essentially done basically everything we can and seen everything we can for right now. Almost everything. Let's head out this way. Okay, we haven't been up here before, but this is quite a pretty little area in the sense that it's got this whole thing going on with the skyline and everything. And I love little shots like this. And this is the other area of the Thimbleweed Park. Oh. This is also beautiful again. But this is the screen that we saw at the very beginning with the birds and everything and the factory in the distance and so on.
Whoa there, little Agent Areno. You can't just go bumbling around the county without a map. It's too easy to get lost. There is a killerino on the loose.
I'm a federal agent. I can take care of myself. A map, seriously? Are there some donuts that need eating? Yeah, you're right. I'll head back to town and find a map. Okay, so we'll start with other donuts that need eating.
Aren't there some donuts that need eating?
Well, you got me there. Oh, those donuts aren't going to eat themselves. But we have laws around here, and everyone is required to have an official map.
Okay. A map? Seriously?
A map? Seriously?
Oh, yes, and not just any map, but an official map.
What does that really mean? But, okay, where would I find this official map?
And where would I find this official map?
Well, the county is plumberino out of them. I guess this really messes up your investigation. I'm sure the head office will understand, Areno. Shall I mark the case as unsolved?
I don't think so. Not a chance. The feds never give up.
Not a chance. The feds never give up. Or should I say, the Fed-arenos never give up.
I see. Now you're mocking me.
Maybe so. Where do I find an official map?
Where do I find an official map?
Well, the county is plumberino-like.
I am a federal agent. I can take care of myself.
And a darn fine agent, I'm sure of. But we have laws around here, and everyone is required to have an official map.
Okay, I'll try this one more time, but I think he says the same thing.
I am a federal agent. I can
And a darn fine... But we have...
Yep, okay, right. Yeah, you're right. I'll head back to town and find a map.
Yeah, you're right. I'll head back to town and find a map.
Ooh, donuts do sound good.
Okay, so... find a map of the Moorweed County. That's a lot easier than it seems. I haven't been careful. Okay. So, we head back to B Street.
Corner of Main and B Streets.
There we go. It finally changed. It is now YouTube. Oh, hang on. Sorry. I went to the wrong spot. I mean, to go to A Street. And here. So, if you'll recall, there's a map here. There's a copied one here. So, we just need to make sure... Oh, there's a speck of dust. We just need to make sure that we can get her out of the office. So we can get that, because if we try to pick up the map right now...
Do you know this map is a priceless first edition? Please, don't touch.
She won't budge on that. So we've got to do some quick and clever thinking.
Please don't mess with the police scanner. I'm waiting for a call from the sheriff's office about a woman by the diner and a possible car accident.
This is interesting to know. We are going to flop to, Agent Reyes. If you recall, there's a police scanner here. So let's try and get that lady to go somewhere else. He's going to have the same list of things that Ray did. We're going to use the scanner to try and lure that lady out of her office.
It's a police radio. Looks like it's on and ready to use.
Sounds good. Okay, so breaker 19, breaker, blah, 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 blah. Daisy, intentional units. I shouldn't be using official counting equipment. This one's the important one, but let's do some of these others.
Daisy, Daisy, give me your answer, do. I'm half crazy, all for the love of you. A bicycle built for two.
Yes, quite a beautiful singing voice. Remember that song, though. It's gonna show up again.
Breaker 19, breaker, breaker.
Okay. So, attention all units.
Attention all units.
See the woman? Near the diner? By the old circus? Up by the old estate? By the dirt road? Any side of town? Near the diner? About a fender bender? Petting a hamster? With an overly fancy hat? Making confetti without a license? Cleaning their fingernails. So, she was talking about an accident?
It's not much, but we're short a story on page 4. I'll be back soon. Don't you touch my map.
And that's, of course, exactly what we're going to do. Let's pick up the map. And use... Before we do that, let's look at the map.
It's a map of the Tri-Thimbleweed Park County area.
Use the map on the scanner, the copy drone.
What a nice copy, and in color too.
And so now we have a map of the county. We can try and put the map that we have, one of the maps, on.
It's a map of the county. This should help me find my way around.
Yeah, but that doesn't work.
Very abstract. Not a great use of color. Though, I do like the subject matter.
So, no matter what we do, we can't actually put that map back together again. Okay. Let's try to head out again. Because remember, the whole thing that was stopping us was the fact that we did not have a map. Here's where we met the sheriff before.
Whoa there, little Agent Areno. Like I said before, you can't just go bumbling around the county without a map.
I have an official map right here.
I have an official map right here.
Oh, I see. Well, that looks legit, Areno. Odd. I thought I... Yeah, well, I guess the law is the law. I guess I'd better return all these maps to the quickie pal.
So he really was.
I feel like we're getting close to cracking this case.
The only thing you're getting close to cracking is my patience with you.
Let's work together and I can get on with my... I mean, we can get out of this town as quickly as possible.
Agreed.
Okay, so it looks like he really was trying to sabotage the works there by stealing all the maps. That's okay. We've got a whole list of things to do here. But let's get cracking. So we need to have a chat with a geeky programmer at the old mansion.
We need to have a chat with a geeky programmer at the old mansion. There is something odd about her.
Yeah, a woman with a brain. Definitely suspicious.
Okay. I don't think he'll say anything different.
We need to have a chat with the geeky programmer. There is...
And we need to have a talk about the crazy old town.
We need to talk to that crazy clown at the circus. He's got serial killer written all over him.
Wouldn't it be quicker to just shoot him?
Ugh. Don't do that.
We need a blood match. using the Bloodtron with a blood swap from the body and Willy's blood wallet.
Okay. We need a fingerprint report? Oh, we have the fingerprint report, sorry.
We have the fingerprint report?
Sure.
And we need to identify the body.
We need to identify the body using the FaceTron with a photo of the body and the victim's photo ID.
You mean like a driver's license or passport?
Or Burger Shack loyalty card recognized around the world?
Yeah, about that. So, okay.
Let's get cracking.
The first thing I'm going to do here is I'm going to give Reyes a map.
Thanks.
The reason why I'm going to do that is because if we go here, the game changes to sort of overhead. And we can go like to spots we've been to before. Main Street, A Street, the bus station, and so on. But we can also go to places we have not been before. We can go there quite fast. So let's go and talk to the clown first. Alright, so there's a couple of things to look at here.
Tickets, 25 cents. The gates are chained and bolted. I can't get in now.
This is not the fence we saw in the opening of the game. But it's interesting to know that they've been chained and bolted too.
It looks like a circus clown horn.
Very creepy.
I remember when those dolls were all the rage. People would wait in line for hours to get one.
Again, that's sort of a riff on the Cabbage Patch dolls. And we can just leave. We don't want to do that, though.
Open up! Federal agents!
Keep your panties on! I'm coming!
Whatever you're selling, I'm not buying. So take your dime store suit and good news pamphlets and stick them where the sun don't shine.
Ransom being ransom. Pizza delivery for Anson the Clown. Anson the Clown? Oh, do you know about a body by the bridge? I'm selling these fine polyester slacks.
I'm selling these fine polyester slacks.
You still there, Red? I thought I told you to off already.
There you go. Pizza delivery for Ransom the Clown.
Pizza delivery for Ransom the Clown.
You still there, Red? I thought I told you to off already.
I heard you know about a body by the river.
Ransom the Clown? I heard you know about a body by the bridge.
Jeez, no foreplay, Red? You don't beat around the bush, do you?
Not my style.
You can ask your questions, Toots, but I'm not saying I'll answer.
That's fair enough, I guess. What do you know about the body by the river? We heard you don't get along with the locals. What do you know about Chuck?
What do you know about Chuck?
Chuck? As in Chuck? My factory is too good to make toys, Edmund? Didn't know the pompous well myself, but I knew his brother Franklin. Weedy guy. Total scared to stand up to his big brother, even though the family business was in the crapper.
How do you know Franklin Edmund?
How do you know Franklin Edmund?
We were supposed to go into business together. My act was about to go bigger than Jesus. I was a hit on the Tonight Show. I was on my way to the top, so we figured why not cash in with a little merchandising. Franklin wanted to get the pillow factory into making toys, so it seemed like a good fit.
Okay, what kind of toys were you planning to make with Franklin?
What kind of toys were you planning to make with Franklin?
Jeez, how do you get by in life without brains or beauty? Isn't it obvious? We were gonna make Ransom the Clown insult dolls. Would have been great if Franklin hadn't bailed on me and gone missing before we signed the contracts. I could have been rich by now if that little toady had grown a backbone.
Okay. Where'd you don't get along with the locals?
We heard you don't get along with the locals.
Given my creepy clown face,
and penchant for abusive name-calling, it's not made me a popular community figure. No. But I don't need the validation of these small-town losers. I'm Ransom the Clown. I was on the Tonight Show. I'm great.
What do you know about the body by the river?
What do you know about the body by the river?
What body?
Earlier this evening, we found a body down by the bridge. We're investigating, and I was told you might have some information for me.
Nah, I heard some sirens before, but I figured they were headed for the mansion. That's where most of the f***ed up stuff happens.
Okay, what weird stuff do you know about at the mansion?
What weird stuff do you know about at the mansion?
You want to find out about the mansion? You're gonna have to talk to some other idiot. I keep to myself and the town folk leave me the f*** alone, thank f***. I'm not about to rock the boat. I don't pay rent here and I can't go anywhere else after my f***ing ex-wife took me for everything I had.
Oh, that's a bit frustrating, but you weren't very nice either, so there you go.
Don't go anywhere. I'll be back.
Whatever, Red. Not like I'm going anywhere, but you're not getting inside without a warrant.
Of course not, he's cursed. Right, okay. So that is it for tonight. Thank you so much for watching. It's episode 8 of Thimbleweed Park. Hope that you're enjoying it as much as I'm enjoying playing it for you. I shall see you all soon. Good night for now, folks.